Plants are the base of the global food web. Plant growth absorbs carbon dioxide and releases oxygen to the atmosphere, and therefore plays a key role in shaping climate on Earth. At least half of the oxygen in the atmosphere comes from the photosynthesis of marine plants, even though vast expanses of the oceans are nearly devoid of plant life. Most of the biological production in the oceans corresponds to the phytoplankton. These microscopic unicellular plants are concentrated in relatively small productive regions on continental shelves or over upwellings of fertile waters. One such region is the shelf break of Patagonia. The phytoplankton production cascades to higher trophic levels. The Patagonian shelf break supports tremendous biodiversity, with species ranging from phytoplankton to top predators, including fish of commercial significance and charismatic marine mammals and birds. We are just beginning to understand how the biological processes over the Patagonian shelf feed into the large-scale ocean circulation, and how its most productive regions will respond to climate changes. Although we know that the ocean is the biggest carbon sink in the world, global carbon models are suspected to miss at least one half of the global ocean carbon flux to the deep ocean. This deficiency not only reflects our lack of understanding of the dynamic processes controlling upwelling and cross-shelf exchanges, but also our lack of information about regions away from the highly developed nations of the Northern Hemisphere.
We work with a team of scientists from Argentina, Brazil, Chile, Uruguay, and the US, and each of us contributes an expertise from the marine physics, the marine biology, and the numerical simulation areas of knowledge. And our main aim is to better understand the physical processes that promote primary production in biological hotspots of the Western South Atlantic. We have analyzed numerical simulations and satellite imagery, and this data shows that the productivity in the Western South Atlantic presents the usual temperate zone characteristic, with a spring bloom that well develops throughout the continental shelf. But then at the end of the season, most of the shelf, the productivity decreases substantially because the nutrients are depleted from the illuminated layer of the ocean.
Generally, the spring bloom over the shelf ends when nutrients are depleted from the illuminated layer. However, in frontal regions on the shelf edge, upward nutrient fluxes are continued through much of the year and sustain the growth of phytoplankton throughout the summer and early fall. Consequently, phytoplankton develops more efficiently around ocean fronts, where other species also concentrate. Growth of marine phytoplankton uses CO2, dissolved in seawater, promoting further uptake of the greenhouse gas by the ocean from the atmosphere. Our surveys over the Patagonian continental shelf and adjacent ocean indicate that the region is an important sink for atmospheric CO2. The Patagonia shelf absorbs about 17 million metric tons of carbon per year, equivalent to all the carbon content of 100,000 hectares of rainforest. The Patagonian shelf break is one of the most important fisheries region on Earth. Today, most experts agree that marine ecosystems are badly overfished and that at the present pace, no fisheries are sustainable. A decrease in fish population could eventually affect zooplankton and phytoplankton communities, thereby disrupting by the ability of the ocean to capture CO2. Such alterations of the marine ecosystem would be analogous to the impact of land use change on the continental carbon budget. These changes are still poorly understood and may bring with them unexpected surprises. Monitoring ocean productivity, carbon budgets, and fisheries it's important to understand options and interventions in the mitigation of greenhouse gas emissions. We will continue to work to better understand the crucial processes that control the ocean carbon cycle and the interactions between the oceans and the atmosphere.